Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it's such a delight to be a part of Thinkation this year. My name is number 16 Oniro. And no, 16 Oniro is not my house address. Yes, 16 Oniro is my real name. I am one of the sons of the immediate past king of Victoria Island, Lagos, Nigeria, in the person of the late Oba Idowu Abiodun Oniro. I've been a comedian for 11 years, and in the first 10 years of my career, I didn't take comedy serious because I was looking forward to my inheritance. And so, in preparation for my inheritance, I had been reading the book of Joshua 5 years prior to the death of my father. I read the book of Joshua because I realized that in the Bible, no other book talks about land sharing like the book of Joshua. And so every day for 5 years, I read the book of Joshua, and I was prophesying that I will have the choicest parts of Victoria Island. Unfortunately, when my father's will was read, I discovered that it's the book of Lamentations that I should have been reading all these years. Now, as the son of a king, I happen to come across various questions that people want to know about the palace and royalty. Some wise, some unwise. And one of the most unwise questions that I encountered recently was when someone walked up to me. He said, Oniro, I said yes. He said, your papa na king, I said yes. He said, damn, is on a they do jazz. I didn't answer. He said, you fit tell us why it be say every time people want drop sacrifice, then they always put them for T junction. I said, that's very easy. People put sacrifices at T junctions because nobody knows which direction the gods are coming from. Now, still on the issue of royalty, the Western world understands that the youths are the leaders of tomorrow. And so in a country like England, where the Queen is 94 and the heir to the throne, Prince Charles, is 72 and his own first son, Prince William, is 38, the English people are already working hard that when the Queen passes on, instead of crowning Prince Charles, who is 72 and too old, Prince William will become the next king. When I found out that this was their plan, I was very sure that when my dad passed, I will become the next king, because among his youthful children, I am the most qualified. I am certified in project management. I am certified in health, safety and environment. I have my business training from one of the best institutes in Nigeria. I am the first of all the Oniro children who attended all levels of education in private schools. I have a BSc from Babcock University in microbiology. I have 2 masters, God and my wife. Yes, those are my 2 masters. Now, with all this, my qualifications, a 50-year-old man was still selected, meaning that even in the palace, the youths are too young to run. Now, in the spirit of love and in the month that we are in, I'm happy to let us know that today is my wedding anniversary. And I know that I look young to you, but I've been married for a very, very long time. Today makes it exactly 72 months that I have been married. Now, I didn't marry a Southwestern woman because I am a Yoruba man. I went all the way to Akwa Ibom to pick a wife. When my father-in-law heard that my name is Oniro, the first question he asked me, have you seen the list? I said, no, sir. He said, bring the list, let him see. When I saw the list, I knew that the transport fare between Akwa Ibom and Rapture is not more than 50 naira bus. First item on the list, in bracket, it was put, non-negotiable. When I checked, it was the price of my wife's wedding gown. When I checked the fee that was attached, I saw 4.652 million. I asked my father-in-law, are you sure this is not money for the full wedding? He said, is it full wedding the road there? I said, no, sir. He said, pay it. I paid that amount for my wife's wedding gown. 2 nights after our wedding, my wife woke me from sleep. She said, baby. I said, yes. She said, I want to dash out my wedding gown. I said, God forbid. We are going to use this wedding gown as mosquito net. To the glory of God, we have been sleeping inside that wedding gown for the past 5 years. None of us has treated malaria. Finally, people ask me, Sisi Oniro, where did you meet your wife? Did you meet her in church? Did you meet her at a party? And I tell people, I met my wife at the gym. Because at some point in my life, people were complaining that my stomach was too big and I should shape up as a bachelor. So on the first day I got to the gym, I saw this beautiful woman. She was on the floor. She was doing press up. It was not the press-up that caught my attention. It was the number of press-up she was doing. Only this beautiful woman was on the floor. She was shouting, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105. So I walked up to her and I said, my sister, can you tell me what is the source of your strength? She said, my brother, don't mind me. I usually start counting from 100. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That is my time.